And great to have you with us on our Yankees Hot Stove segment here on YesNetwork.com. Bob Lorenz, John Flaherty, and Jack Curry with you. So, again, T's need to be crossed. I's need to be dotted. Physical has to be taken. But the Yankees lock up another key bullpen piece, Adam Ottavino, for 3 years.
Right, and they bring in a pitcher with a nasty slider. His two-seam fastball is also a pitch that he started to use even more. And they bring in someone, Bob, who just makes an already strong bullpen even stronger. I mean, you look at the pitchers that the Yankees have at the back end of their bullpen, the ability to generate swings and misses, which is something that Ottavino can do. Averaged 13 strikeouts per 9 innings last year. And that slider is just nasty. It's just this frisbee-like quality to it. And with the movement on the two-seamer, I mean, he's got pitches going in both directions.
You know, Brian Cashman getting the job done with the bullpen. You lose Robertson, you bring in Ottavino, you bring Britton back, you already had Chapman, you had Betances. So to Jack's point, the swing and misses out of that bullpen, you're eliminating the defensive problems maybe that you might have had last year by getting all those strikeouts. And now the question is, how is Aaron Boone going to use a guy like Ottavino? Is it going to be in the middle of the game? Is it going to be late in big-time situations? You figure Chapman's going to close, Betances is going to set up with Britton. So there's going to be some flexibility there with this guy with a great slider that Jack is talking about.
And is it fair to say different look for this bullpen compared to what opponents have seen in the past? Robertson had that cutter, but he was another power arm. We know that Ottavino can throw hard, but it's that slider that's so different from maybe what any other Yankee throws.
Yeah, definitely a different look. And I think when you look at the bullpen as a whole, I know some people might say, well, they brought Britton back, and now they're just trading out Ottavino for Robertson. Well, it's going to be a full season of Britton, and I think Britton's going to be a lot better in 2019 than he was in 2018. And I think Robertson has a more extended track record of what he has done. But Ottavino, if he can repeat what he did last year, this guy was one of the best relievers in baseball. So I think the improvements are there. Chad Green and Holder are guys also who are younger, and you expect them to get better. I mean, that is such a deep bullpen.
I hate to say it, are Holder and Green afterthoughts now, right? I mean, you're talking about these big four guys out of the bullpen, and Ottavino also added a cutter last year that kind of bridged the gap from the fastball to the slider and was a big pitch for him. So he's a New York guy who's coming to the New York Yankees. You would expect that to be a comfortable transition, but like anybody else who comes to the Yankees, you have to see it before you really feel 100% comfortable. But I think about this bullpen as a whole. I mean, it's going to be one of the best, obviously, in baseball. You got a guy like Tommy Canley. Is he going to rebound? He's out of options, so that's going to be an interesting arm to pay attention to as well.
Yeah, and tune into our show because we're going to talk about how Ottavino might have saved his career. There's a great article on FanGraphs about how he basically used a storefront in Harlem that's between a dollar shoe store and a Chuck E. Cheese, and that's where he worked out two off seasons ago. Fantastic story by Travis Sawchuk. We'll talk about it on our show.
All right, sounds good. We thank you for joining us here on YesNetwork.com. And don't forget to check out the website for all the latest Yankees news throughout the offseason.